Good afternoon, leaders, shipmates, and honorary guests. I'm Benjamin Lusk, and I'm representing DMS and DDS, the USS Kilmer. So our goals today are to highlight the importance of the US Navy during World War II, and to remember and pay tribute to all the fallen sailors and to the millions of victims and survivors of the Holocaust. During World War II, the US Navy fought in every ocean of the world, and in many of history's biggest battles, including the attack on Pearl Harbor, the Battle of Coral Sea, the Battle of Midway, the Battle of the Philippine Sea, the Battle of Leyte Gulf, and the Battle of Okinawa. And although the Navy's efforts had a huge impact on winning the war and ending the mass genocide, we could do nothing to prevent the suffering and loss of lives already taken, including 62,614 sailors, and the systematic murder of over 6 million Jews worldwide. So for our presentation, we've decided that the best way to pay tribute and to remember those that we lost is to honor those who were fortunate enough to survive. We'd like to do this by highlighting three people. So to start it off, our first person that we'll be talking about is QM1 George Mendonca. So after Japan's 1941 attack on Pearl Harbor, Mendonca felt compelled to quit his job as a civilian sailor and to instead enlist himself in the United States Navy. He was stationed on the USS Sullivan in the Pacific Fleet, quickly rising to the rank of quartermaster first class. On May 11, 1945, off the coast of Okinawa, two Japanese kamikaze bombers bombed the USS Bunker Hill, killing more than 350 crew members almost instantly, leaving countless others stranded to die either on board or jumped from the ship. However, the USS Sullivan, which was QM1 Mendonca's ship, was the closest ship to the Bunker Hill during the attack. QM1 Mendonca's and the rest of his shipmates became the many saviors of many of the Bunker Hill crew that day, pulling many men from the water and ensuring the safety and saving many of the men who had been badly injured. Okay, so our second person we'll speak about today is not only a Holocaust survivor, but also a Jewish refugee named Greta Zimmer. Greta was born to a Jewish family in 1924 in the country of Austria. In 1938, after Germany's annexation of Austria, the Zimmers came under direct threat of the Nazi regime. Greta's parents felt that to keep their three daughters safe, they had to get them out of Europe as quickly as possible. So Greta's parents secured passports for the girls, allowing them to secretly immigrate to the United States. And although her parents ensured their children's safe escape, Greta's parents had to stay back in Austria to face the Nazi Germany. Greta's story reveals the harsh realities that face many Jews unable to escape the Holocaust. So our third and last person is a Holocaust survivor and Jewish refugee by the name of Alfred Eisenstadt. Alfred Eisenstadt was born to a Jewish family that settled in Berlin in the early 1900s. After serving in World War I, Alfred returned to Germany and took up photography, teaching himself the basics. After the Nazi rise to power in January 1933, the Eisenstadt family, like all Jews living in Germany, under the threat of the regime's oppressive laws, the family immigrated to the United States in the mid-1930s, narrowly escaping Nazi persecution. Alfred utilized his newfound freedom by pursuing his first love, his photography career in the city. So you just heard about those three amazing people. Not only three amazing people, but three very different people. People from different backgrounds, different parts of the world. All had one very similar thing that all connected them together. A photo. I don't know if you've seen it or not. You got the girl, you gotta have somebody to take it. Photographs tell us a great deal about a moment in time. They leave an everlasting record of who, what, when, and where, but pictures only convey what the eye can see. Even the most familiar photos, such as this, can have surprising backstories like we just told you. So the day Japan surrendered, on August 14th, 1945, World War II and the Holocaust genocide had finally ended. These three incredible survivors who by chance were in the same place at the same time unexpectedly created one of America's most iconic photographs of World War II, which became symbolic of the very moment of war. Alfred Eisenstadt's famous photo captured a fleeting moment that made a lasting impression. We see the impact of the war and the Holocaust had on people's lives. The kissing, still, he resisted every day. Today, we carry forward the proud legacy of men and women of the U.S. Navy who played an essential role as a part of the American forces. Our Navy not only secured freedom for the survivors of Nazi wars, it also ensured that the world would know about all that had happened. We, the Sailor 360, DMS, and DDS team, hope that from now on, whether you see them painted on the wall, put up in a photo frame, or reenacted on TV, the next time you see Greta and George in that famous, infamous pose, you take what we presented you today and educate those around you. But you also honor and, most importantly, never forget the millions of victims gone. Thank you very much.